Yo, what's good, YouTube? Early morning here, 7:15 in the morning on a Sunday. So today you're gonna see daily routine of what I eat in a day. It's a standard everyday breakfast, meal one. So I woke up around 5:30. I wake up about 5:30 every morning. First thing I did when I wake up, 10 ounces of water and a shot of apple cider vinegar. First thing I do when I start my day every day, fresh out of bed, I walk right to the fridge. I drink 10 ounces of water. Now, how I measure the ounces, I literally just take 10 big gulps, and on the 10th gulp, I take the shot of apple cider vinegar, and that's it. Boom. Start my morning off. I go walk my dog, get a little walk in. By that time, I'm ready to use the bathroom. Now it's 7:15. I did a little work prior. I went, walked the dog, worked a little bit on the computer, did some programs. Now we're here for meal one, standard breakfast that I have every day. Now if you guys have listened to previous videos that I posted on other channels, you'll know I'm big on gut health. So I always start off first thing in the morning with sauerkraut. First thing I eat is wild fermented sauerkraut. It's got good probiotics, good for your gut health. It's like a primer for your gut and for your intestinal tract, for everything else that's to come for the day. It's gonna help you absorb and assimilate all the nutrients that are to come from the meals following. Right after the sauerkraut, I put down bone broth. Here, hope you guys can see. All right, so once I put down some sauerkraut and finish drinking the broth, I get onto the meal. Here I have two full eggs and 150 grams of egg whites with a side of pasture-raised nitrate-free bacon. And then 140 grams of blueberries, one cup. So it's a standard breakfast. Sauerkraut first, homemade bone broth, two whole eggs with 150 grams of egg whites with some pasture-raised bacon and blueberries to go. For those who have seen my videos on That's Good Money's channel, you guys have probably heard that I like to keep my pre-workout meals, meaning whatever I eat before I work out for the day, mainly as proteins and fats. If I'm gonna have any kind of carbohydrate source, it's gonna be from a fruit or a green. It's not gonna be any starch. You won't see me eat any bread, potatoes, legumes, nothing like that before a workout. So it tends to be berries early in the morning if I'm gonna have a fruit. And then pre-workout, all I really have is a banana and some spinach in my pre-workout shake, which you'll see later to come. So like I said, carb sources before workout, I tend to keep them to just berries and mostly, mainly high protein, moderate fat sources of food. So you wanna get your body into almost that ketosis state for the beginning half of the day, optimize fat burning. Post-workout, you start consuming your carbs, which will again optimize the carbohydrate storage as glycogen in the muscles post-workout. As opposed to loading up on carbohydrates before a workout, your body has nowhere to store them. They're going to get stored as fat and then just burned off as energy during the workout. Whereas if you're using your fat for a fuel source during your workout, your body's going to be in a mainly fat-burning state during the workout and up until the post-workout window when you start taking in the carbs and you're very more anabolic and more insulin sensitive.
And like always, my man Scrap gets all the scraps. 11 years old, looking like he's 5 still, guys. You eat well, you live well. That don't just go for humans. Treat your animals and your pets the same way. My dog eats good, he looks good. And that's how we live out here.
All right, let's clarify. So what I was saying previously about being in a ketosis state for the early start of the day or for the first half of the day, what I mean is you can manipulate your body and teach your body to be in different cycles throughout the day. You don't have to be on a strict keto diet to reap the benefits of ketosis. You don't have to eat high carbs all day to reap the benefits of performance training. Now, when people tend to be taking gear or doing all these external illegal substances and abusing all these external things, your body's a lot more resilient in the sense of fat burning, muscle retention, and utilizing these nutrients, because remember now, guys, you're putting in something illegal, that's something, it's an enhancer. Now, aside from that, eating correctly in the mornings and prior to training, the way I think it should be done is high protein, moderate fats, up until your training routine. So the meals prior to training, you want to keep them high quality protein, healthy source of fats, and low carbohydrate intake. If I, like I said, if I'm going to take in any carbohydrate, you're going to see me eating berries or a banana pre-workout. And that's pre-workout, meaning I've been up for like 6 or 7 hours for the day already, active, moving around, walking, training clients. So that banana is actually going to be used to replenish some of the stores that I've burnt for the morning. I'm not using it as fuel for my training. It's going to replenish what I've already burned through for the day. So now getting into the ketosis in the morning part. If you can manipulate your body to run on fats and proteins for the earlier part of the day, when it comes to training and that post-workout window, you're going to be a lot more insulin sensitive, meaning your body's going to be a lot more resilient at uptaking those carbohydrate sources that you feed it after you train. Carbohydrates stored in the muscle get stored as glycogen, and they're only going to get stored as glycogen when the muscles are broken down and need to be topped off. So if you're doing a resistance training session and you're breaking down the muscles, after you train, they need to be replenished. And how do you replenish them? By eating carbohydrates. Now, when you eat those carbohydrates post-workout, your body converts them into what's called glycogen. Glycogen gets stored in the muscle. Glycogen does not get stored as fat. What I'm saying is optimizing that post-workout window to utilize the carb intake is when your body's going to really take in those carbs and put them to use. They're going to be stored as fuel for the next workout in the muscles, and most of it will not be stored as fat. It will just be dispersed throughout the bloodstream and burned out throughout the day. What's good? We're back. So, since this is a full day of eating video, technically this is the third thing I'm consuming for the day. First thing upon rising, apple cider vinegar, 10 ounces of water. Second, breakfast, sauerkraut, bone broth, eggs, bacon, blueberries. Now, it's about 2 hours after breakfast, and every day I have a black coffee. Straight up, black coffee. I stress that I get organic beans all the time, and I would recommend everyone else get organic coffee. That's because coffee itself, the crop, is one of the most chemically treated crops on the land. It's sprayed abundantly with pesticides and herbicides. A lot of genetically modified ingredients could go into that coffee itself that you're drinking, then you'd be taking that yourself. So I stress organic coffee blends, and I drink it straight black. Nothing in it, no sweeteners, no dairy, no creamers, nothing to make it light, just straight black organic roast coffee. What up? We back cooking in the kitchen with the Prez, and here we are for meal two. So I have my breakfast first, my coffee. Now you're gonna see my standard meal that I have 95% of the days, as long as my days are going accordingly. If I'm in New York and not traveling, this is the standard meal that I have every day. Usually it's my pre-workout meal, and today, since I'm not training, it's just gonna be used as my meal anyways. So like I said, standard meal no matter what, if I'm training or if I'm not training. Now if I'm training, you would see I may add an extra serving of banana in it, but today, since I'm not training, it's just gonna be one banana, and I'm gonna go through the whole ingredient list with you right now. So what we have in this is a pre-workout shake on a training day or my meal two. So ignore the bag, I finished it. So we use a half a bag of raw spinach, 70 grams of sea moss. This is Griffin moss that I get off my boy. You guys need a hookup, hit me up. I'll send you his contact info. One serving, which is 32 grams of organic peanut butter. I put today one medium banana. It weighs about around 120 grams. Now, if this is a training day, I would put maybe 150 grams of banana in just to have a little more carbs, since I would have already been exhausting myself prior to training from training my clients. And just so I have a little energy going into my workout, I mix it with 8 ounces of almond milk, organic, unsweetened, No extra sugars, guys. And I top it off with one scoop of whey isolate. This is around 20, 22 grams of protein. It's grass-fed. Like always recommend grass-fed anything that's coming from an animal. So I'm gonna blend this up, and today, like I said, I'm prepping it. So I'm gonna blend it, throw it in a mason jar, and it's 94 degrees here today, taking my ass to the beach. So it's an on-the-go meal for the day, but regardless, like I said, standard meal two from my day-to-day life. Now we're gonna blend that all up. I got a Vitamix. So you guys can see, it gives it this green, brownish tint. Well, I use chocolate protein powder to give it the darker tint. The green's obviously from the spinach. And I'm gonna pack this up in a cooler bag and take this to the beach. This has around 480 calories the way it is right now. If I would've put a little more banana in, would've been just over the 500 calorie mark. And like I said, pre-workout meal if I'm training, have an extra banana. But since I'm not training today, this is just my meal too. Gonna be amazing. All right, so now I'm gonna give you guys a little insight of what I put in my water that I drink throughout the day and what I drink in my water if I'm training. So today, we're just gonna prepare it for a non-training day. So what I put in my water on the reg, this is a 40 ounce insulated bottle. I got it filled almost to the top so I could have room to shake it when it's all mixed, when all the powders are put in. So every day, I put one scoop of glutamine powder, one scoop of creatine monohydrate, raw, micronized, one scoop of Thorn amino complex. You don't have to use the Thorn brand, just an essential aminos. This is a full amino complex. It's not just the BCAAs, it has all nine amino acids, all nine essential aminos in it. So now, since it's an off day, I'll just be sipping on this throughout my day. And like I said, it's 40 ounces of water. It'll probably last me 2-3 hours. Then I'll refill it with water and I'll just drink water for the rest of the day. But now, if I was training, all of this would be in this bottle. So I would have drank all of this in the morning from upon rising. And then while I train, I would have made another one and I would have put this unflavored performance intra-workout powder. It's a carb powder. It's organic, hydrolyzed carbohydrates. It's a split of maltodextrin and dextrose, and they label it as a pre and intra workout. I use it as an intra or post-workout carb source. So this is what you're gonna see in my water that I drink in my videos, days that I'm training really hard, or just about a training day in general, especially if I'm training in the sun. So carb powder, creatine, glutamine, aminos in water for while I'm training. Off day, no carb powder because we don't need the fast digesting carbs to be absorbed because we're not breaking down any muscle. And just a little tip, the reason why I put all this in a water while I train is while you're training, your body's at a heightened sense to take up nutrients. The blood is rushing to the working muscles. So if you ingest powders and supplements like this with no calories in it, your body is gonna absorb it and the blood is gonna rush it to the working muscles. So it's an optimal time to deliver nutrients to the working muscles. So if you're doing a set of bench press, if you're doing a set of push-ups, your chest is actively working, blood is actively being pumped to the chest muscles. If you're sipping on this while you're training, as soon as it hits your bloodstream, all these nutrients are being pumped right into the working muscles. They're being stored to be used as energy and stored to help facilitate recovery and prolong muscle breakdown. Let's go, lunchtime, back in the kitchen. So like I said, today's an off day, but this is my standard lunch that I would have if I was training or if I had taken off. So what you're gonna see here, every day, you guys know I like to eat red meat. I'm a big proponent on grass-fed meat. So today, I got a beef petite tender, filet mignon, 0.8 of a pound. I'm gonna share this with my girl. I got now, standard, on a regular day, If I was training, all I would have is more rice in this bowl. Today, since it was an off day, all I have is 120 grams of white rice. So, like I say, guys, I like to keep my meals simple. Post-workout or not, if I was training, this would be an ideal post-workout meal. Protein and carbs. You want to keep the food easily digestible. Simple ingredients, whole foods. White rice, very easily digestible carbs. As soon as you're done working out, it'll be stored right in the muscles as glucose. Especially if you're doing a high protein, a higher fat, low carb diet before your training. Now, if I was training also, all I would have had prior to this meal is my aminos, which you saw in the previous clip. And in the aminos, I would have had the carb powder. So all I was drinking on today is my aminos and my water. And now it's lunchtime, so it's just a filet mignon, lean piece of meat, red meat, grass-fed, with 120 grams of rice today. So if I was training, and if this was a training day, you would have seen this rice with about 200, 250 grams of rice right here. So the only thing that's different on a training day to an off day from my lunch is the amount of carbs I'm eating in the afternoon. So today, low carb. I have no carb powder in the drink. It's just aminos and now 120 grams of rice. So if it was a training day, 200 to 250 grams of rice, depending on the session that went down. And I would have had the 2 scoops of carb powder in the water bottle mixed with the aminos. And that's it. I'm going to cook this up. When it's done, I'll show you guys the final product.
Here we go. Final product. We got 10 ounces after being cooked of filet mignon. 120 grams of rice. And a little extra today. Some spinach and garlic. Some feta cheese. Low carb meal. Mm-hmm. Now if this was post workout on a training day, you would just see the rice increased.
Well, it's good. We're back. Back in the kitchen with the Prez. It's dinner time. And so you already know today's an off day. So you can see the only thing that would change normally with this meal is I may have had some gluten-free oats with it, a potato, if I had trained prior. But today this is gonna be a high fat, high protein meal. Yo, what's good? We're back in the kitchen. It's dinner time. I'm gonna be rushed right now because I got a client coming in about an hour. So I'm gonna cook this meal up. Remember, it was an off day. So it's gonna be high protein, more high fat, moderate carb meal. Now if I was a training day, if I had trained prior in the day, this meal may have had more carbs in it. Probably saw a potato in it, maybe some oatmeal. But this is a standard meal that I eat pretty much every single day. You're gonna have egg whites, 2 whole eggs. I got smoked lox, wild caught smoked lox, which is smoked salmon. I got 4 ounces of that. I got 100 grams of raspberries. So it's gonna be 150 grams of egg whites, 2 whole organic eggs. We're gonna scramble the egg whites and the 2 whole eggs together. We're cooking this meal in organic extra virgin olive oil spray, 0 calorie. So we're gonna scramble the egg whites with the 2 whole eggs. When that's done, we're gonna plate it with the 4 ounces of smoked salmon and the 100 grams of raspberries. Dinner for the day. I'm gonna cook this up right now. And when I plate it, you guys will see the final product.
Here we go, the meal is done. It's a very simple meal to prepare, guys. It took me, no lie, less than 10 minutes. So we got the 2 whole eggs, 150 grams of egg whites, 4 ounces of smoked salmon, wild caught. I got 100 grams of raspberries right there. It's a little over, it's probably like 120. And water. This is dinner for the day. I'm gonna eat this, go train, a client that is, and you'll see me back later for the final meal of the day.
Back in the kitchen with the Prez. And tonight we're gonna be making my protein pancakes. If you follow me on IG, you're going to see me posting these about 4 or 5 times a week. I have them just about every single night. They go towards my calories every day. You guys want to, looking for a healthy dessert option, something sweet that you need to eat at night to satisfy a sweet tooth or a craving. These are a great option. They're very low fat, high protein, moderate carb. Again, they're always gluten free. Everything you see me eat is going to be gluten free on my channel. I don't mess with gluten. Only dairy you're really gonna see me eat is my whey protein, a little bit of Greek yogurt. You won't see me drinking milk, eating cheese like that. So tonight, like I said, protein pancakes, very simple, guys. Minimal ingredients, you can count them on your hands. So for the base, we're gonna put all these in a blender, NutriBullet, whatever you got. We're gonna just blend it up. So we're gonna start 45 grams of gluten-free oats. ...100 grams of liquid egg whites. This is what's gonna make the liquid of the base. This is basically gonna be the main ingredient of the base, the protein, part of the protein pancakes. Tonight we're gonna use 2 bananas since these are rather small. If I had a bigger banana, it might've just been one. But like I said, 2 bananas, I'll put 1.5 in the base and I'll keep half for a topping. And then we're just gonna put one more scoop of whey protein. Chocolate flavor. This is optional. You don't have to put this in. They're already going to have a sufficient amount of protein with the egg whites and everything else combined, along with the toppings that you're going to see I put on in a minute. So, like I said, we're going to blend up 45 grams of oats, 100 grams of egg whites, 1.5 of these bananas, and 1 scoop of whey protein. That's going to be the base.
All right, so this is everything I just told you blended up as the base. We have the egg whites, we have the oats, the 1.5 bananas, and the scoop of whey. That's why you see the chocolate, the brownish color flavor, because I use chocolate covered protein on these guys. Don't forget that. So also right now I have going 2 pans. So this is probably gonna make about 8 or 9 pancakes right now. 8 or 9 small pancakes. 2 pans heated up with organic virgin coconut oil. This is what you're always going to see me cooking in. I cook in coconut oil, I cook in ghee, and I cook in extra virgin organic olive oil. But when I'm making my pancakes, I make them in coconut oil, gives them a nice crisp on the outside, that nice sweet flavor goes really well with the pancakes. So 2 pans heated up. I'm gonna get these going, show y'all the final product.
All right, I got both pans set. I got 6 going so far. Got a little batter left. Think these ones are ready to flip, actually. Let's see. Going, I'm gonna go through my toppings. Now, the toppings are gonna make them really, really anabolic. Anabolic protein pancakes here. Even more protein for the topping. So what you're gonna see now, you're gonna see me make my topping. I always top my pancakes with non-fat organic Greek yogurt, grass-fed Greek yogurt. But the key here, guys, so the Greek yogurt alone has 16 grams of protein, 0 grams of fat, 6 grams of carbs, only 4 grams of sugar, no added sugar. It's plain. I get plain flavored, no added shit, no flavors. Alright, so into that yogurt, the topping, I'm going to put 1 scoop of collagen protein. 1 scoop is another 10 grams of protein. So now, bam, that topping right there, 26 grams of protein. 16 grams from the yogurt, 10 more grams from the collagen. I'm going to mix that up. Let me flip my pancakes. Hold up. Alright, so 1 scoop of collagen protein in the non-fat organic Greek yogurt. Mix it all up.
Shade, stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I whip it like a
slave. It mixes really smooth, guys. No flavor in the collagen protein. The yogurt is plain. You don't taste anything. Tastes like the yogurt was just fresh open, nothing in it. 26 grams of protein in this little thing right here.
And whip it like a slave.
Take these 3. Ready to go. Boom. 1, 2, 3. Set. All right. A little more coconut oil in the pan.
See, I wake up in the morning, take a shit, shower, shave, stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I whip it like a slave, whip it like a slave. Stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I wake up in the morning, take a shit, shower, shave, stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I whip it like.
Alright, so those ingredients alone, the 45 grams of oats, the egg whites, the banana and a half, scoop of protein, and made already 6 pancakes. I got 2 more medium-sized ones already going, so 8 pancakes. And this is real low calories. I'll put the calories up on the screen when everything's complete. Total calories with the toppings and everything. But this is a good amount of food. This is filling. And again, very high protein, low fat, moderate carb meal. So you can see me top off these 6 that I got. So I'm going to just take this yogurt with the collagen mixed in already. And I'm going to start, boom, topping them off right like that. Bomb.
Maestro. See, I wake up in the morning, take a shit, shower, shade. Uh-huh. Stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I whip it like a slave. Whip it like a slave. Stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I wake up in the morning, take a shit, shower, shade. Stand over the stove and whip it.
We got more toppings.
I whip it like a slave. I whip it like a slave. Stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I wake up in the morning, take a shit, shower, shade. Stand over the stove and whip it like a slave. I whip it like a slave.
You're seeing, I rinsed off a few organic raspberries. So I always like to put some fruit on top. So here you're gonna see, I got the Greek yogurt on, rinsed off some raspberries. I'm gonna throw some raspberries on top of these. I'm gonna start stacking them. You know you gotta have a stack, guys, stack. If it ain't stacked, it ain't right. You know what I'm talking about, stacks.
Face. Check my pockets, more money than rent.
Big stacks. My pancakes are home, creatine. If you don't know that, I don't know.
Big stacks, my pockets on creatine.
Nah, I'm just kidding, but it's a Lil Wayne verse.
Yes, I heard.
3.
I love this shit. So let me talk my shit.
8 pancakes out of that. 8 total. I'm gonna show you guys. Hold it up. Alright, we ain't done yet. We ain't done yet, yo. Chill out.
Yeah.
So, Greek yogurt, berries. Next, honey. Raw, organic, unfiltered honey. That's what I top my pancakes with. I don't use maple syrup. I do here and there, but I prefer honey over maple syrup. So, final product. Look at that. Look at that. Eight pancakes stacked. Macros to come. Alright, so that's a wrap for the full day of eating. Total calories for the day are about 2,800. Now remember, this is an off day for me. I didn't train myself. I went to the beach. I trained 1 client. I had a pretty chilled out day. I didn't break down any muscle myself. So for me, the calories were a little lower and the carbs were lower. So the only difference that you would see on a training day, my calories would be around 3,200. And the increase of those calories would come from about 100 grams of carbs more that I would eat throughout the day just by adding more rice, more bananas, a little more fruit, maybe some oatmeal to my meals throughout the day. So this is a standard day of eating, off day. The only thing that would change on an on day would be increase of carbs from just putting more rice, like I said, more fruit, a little more oats into the meals that you see right there. These are staples that I eat every day, guys. So you're gonna see the total calories, total macros for this day at the end of this clip. Thanks for watching. Peace out. Hey yo, don't forget, like, comment, subscribe, Barnaturals.